Good morning and welcome to the lecture series of National Services Scheme NSS of Dialbagh Educational Institute, Agra. I'm Dr. Arun Pratap Sikarwar and shall be the moderator of this presentation. We are glad to have with us today Mr. A.S. Umasankar, who is serving as Assistant Director of Central Footwear Training Institute, CFTI, Agra. The CFTI is one of the prestigious autonomous body functioning under the aegis of Central Government Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises. The CFTI is a leading educational center for shoe training in our country. Mr. Umasankar is a footwear technologist by his profession and is having a professional degree in leather technology from prestigious University of Madras, Chennai. He had earned a degree of Masters of Business Administration or MBA and several other certificate courses in the footwear designing and manufacturing. Altogether, he is having more than 20 years of academic and industrial experience in the footwear and allied industry. Presently, Umasankar is a senior officer at CFTI Agra and is having 9 years hands-on experience in conducting different skills and entrepreneurship development training programs. He has conducted different central and state government-sponsored training programs under the scheme of different ministries, including Department of Science and Technology, DST. Apart from this, he is the coordinating officer for the development of curriculum of different postgraduate and advanced certificate courses conducted by not only CFTI, but even other institutes working in the leather industries throughout the country. Besides, he has taken the responsibility to coordinate the activities of the Entrepreneurship Development Cell or EDC at CFTI Agra to help and guide the aspirants in coordination with different central and state government agencies. Now, I would like to welcome Mr. Umasankar to deliver his presentation. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Arun Pratap Sikarwar, sir. Happy morning, my dear students. I am really delighted and excited to interact with you in this wonderful morning session, because I see this is a very good opportunity for me to interact with you and to share something about footwear industry and the scope of footwear industry and the role of CFTA for the footwear industry. So the topic we are going to discuss is the scope of footwear industries and career opportunities in footwear industry. So I will start the session now. So to start with, first of all, I would like to update you that footwear industry plays a very significant role in the country's socio-economical development. If you see the socio-economical development, in the sense, it will give a overall development in the country's GDP, the population's lifestyle, the per capita income, the purchasing power of the peoples, the availability of all type of social and economical benefits. Moreover, you can see this industry, the other major thing that we can really look into is the financial aspect. It is directly and indirectly creating the revenue of 50,000 crores per year throughout this country through this business. Not only that, 50,000 crore, out of that 18,000 crore is mainly for export market. If you know very good, you know very well, you all know very well, whenever we are exporting to the other countries, we are getting advantage of our money exchange value. So we should balance the export and import, and footwear is one of the product which is managing the import export ratio of this country. Not only that, this footwear industry, the India plays a very big role in terms of manufacturing footwear products. India is the second largest footwear producer after China. China is the first in this world, and comparatively we are in the second position, and we are making 2.1 billion pairs per year. I can tell you it is 200 crores pair of footwear. 200 crore pairs of footwear India is making, Indian footwear industry is making. And the overall global production is 16 billion pairs. so 1600. This you can understand that 13% of the global footwear is manufactured in India. So we can understand such a big industry and we are talking about. However, you can see, in as you know, the Indian population, out of our internal production, the 90% of the footwear consumed by our in our country itself. And only the 10% of the products are exported to different countries, especially European Union or European nations, I can say, where they are consuming our products largely in large numbers. And also you can see the consuming part, like how when we are consuming internally, domestic consumption of footwear is more, you know, as I told you. But our per capita consumption, like per head Indian population, as per the data, if you see, only 1.66 pair shoes or footwear used by one person. But if you see the developed countries, one person average, they are having 7 to 10 pairs of shoes. So you can understand, in India till today, many people don't have the footwear, or many people don't have the facility to use footwear or purchase footwear because they are bothered about their bread and butter. They don't have the money, or they don't have the accessibility to purchase a good footwear. So in overall data, you can understand the per capita, like per one person, how much footwear they are consuming, 1.66 pair. But if you see the developed countries, they are into 7 to 10 pairs of footwear they are consuming. Their conception is there. So obviously we have to work to provide a quality and low cost footwear to the Indian population so that they can purchase the footwear and use it. Not only that, Indian footwear retail market CAGR, you know what is CAGR, compound annual growth rate. It is almost 20%. The retail market is booming in this area, and you can always expect a high number of business or huge volume of business in this particular industry. Apart from that, some important facts I want to share, really interesting fact, is that it is a highly labor intensive industry. What is labor intensive? Here, labor intensive stands for that when you want to make a footwear, we have to involve a lot of human operations. We have to go through human based operations, because it is not 100% automated. Whether we have to go for manual operations and semi-automatic operations and automatic operations. So we can understand it is directly providing a job for lot of people. Like here, as per the data, you can see 1.3 million, that is 13 lakhs people in India are involved directly in manufacturing or production of footwear. And out of that, 35% of these 13 lakhs are from weaker section. The weaker section, I mean that financially and due to other reasons, they are involved and they are earning their bread and butter from this industry. So it is, first, as I told you, it is highly generating foreign revenue to this country in terms of monetary performance and other things. Same time, it is giving the labor jobs to the laborers, Indian populations. But how the India become a market? What is the reason? That we have to understand, like India, the reason for footwear hub is that one of the main reason is it is raw material based. You know, when we are making footwears, mostly we are talking about leather. So India, our country, is having very good source of raw material, particularly cattle and buffalo. Like if I say normally cow, buffalo, goat, sheep, these are the materials, leather, these are the animals where its skins are used for making footwears. So you can see the 21% of cattle and buffaloes and 11% of goat and sheep population of the world are from Indian country. So you can understand how big and the source of raw material we are getting. Not only that, we are having easy accessibility to new designs, technologies, and international markets. Because of the raw material base and the workforce, India is making and exporting for a lot of international customers. You can see some of the customer name we have given. You might also come across these brands: Marks and Spencer, Nike, Reebok, Clarks, Florisham, Eco Shoes, Gabor Shoes. There are a lot of these all MNC companies, multinational companies. They are purchasing the footwear from India and they are selling through retail chain stores in different parts of the world. So you can understand Indian products are going to foreign country and it got sold out there, that you can understand how our quality standards are maintained. Not only that, other domestic brands also we can discuss, like, you know, Bata, Liberty, Relaxo, Metro and Metro, Red Chief, Red Tape, Kadims. These are domestic brands. They are also exporting. However, these brands are having a very good presence pan-India shops, and they are having a sourcing chain and they are purchasing and they are selling in their brand as per their quality standards. So you can see overall the leather, non-leather and footwear components are almost the business volume of the business is 18,000 crores, is a very big money. You can understand the importance. The reason why we are discussing this, you can understand what it's a very big market and there are a lot of job opportunities are there and there are a lot of scope to improve in terms of technology, in terms of designs and other aspects. So you can see normally the business, any business, if you see, they depends upon various factors. So some factors we are listed out here in the slides, you can go through. One is the market demand. The things depends upon the how the market works. Whenever there is a demand, there will be a supply, and the price and factor will be fixed based on the demand supply factors and other. Then it depends upon the technology, then the raw material. Always raw material is very important to produce any product. So when it comes to footwear, we are having raw material source. It is not a high cost thing, we can afford and we can set up industries. And the trade practice. When it comes to trade practice, what is the universal standards, size, systems, materials, this all coming into that, and it should be a fair trade practice. And the skill and training. Again, CFTA is holding this responsibility of skilling and training, because this footwear industry is such an industry where it is mostly labor oriented and skill oriented. The person who are working, they are classified into semi-skilled, unskilled and skilled category. So based on their skill, they have to improve their skill, that is skill upgradation. They have to upgrade the skills, they have to get a proper training, and they are equipped to use latest machineries and technologies to produce a quality footwear. Then if you see the profitability and rate of return, any business demands a proper timely return of money with a profit. So it is also an important factor which depends, creates the person to start a business. Then environmental issue, where how the impact of solid waste, liquid waste, air waste or air pollution or any type of waste, how it is generated, how it is handled, whether it is creating issues to the local population or other things, that has to be studied. Then the modernization and expansion scopes. In this business, what is the saturation level, where new technologies are available, or how we can improve ourselves and other things. Other important thing is the government policy and incentive scheme. It is very important that without the government support, we can't do anything. But government should have a favorable policy and they should have a incentive supports for purchasing machineries, exporting products and facilities of proper roads or infrastructures, industrial areas, power supply, labor training. There are many things government can do and the industries can get benefited, and that infrastructure. So these are the major areas where the depends upon where the industry's growth is possible or not possible, is affected by those factors. Then if I say like Indian footwear industry, you can see some SWOT analysis we have did, like what are all the strengths, weakness and opportunities and threats faced by the Indian footwear industry. So coming first with the strength, as you know, like already we are doing this much business, so without strength we can't do anything. So these are the major strengths of Indian footwear industry. First, I can start with the domestic market potential, because there are a lot of clusters. If I say Agra is the footwear hub of India, and in Agra there are more than 250 export oriented units are functioning. I can say the export oriented units in the sense they are having mechanized and semi-automatic machineries, technologies, buying officers, overseas officers, multiple manufacturing plants, and they are mostly dealing with export units like MNC, multinational companies. So Indian strength, I can say it's a market potential. Then raw material base, we are having a sufficient availability of raw material. I can say the leather or the other materials. Then labor force, we have a proper trained, skilled labor force, semi-skilled labor force to do the day-to-day production. Then our Indian designers and Indian team, they are having a very good R&D, research and development concept, experience, expertise, available knowledge about the latest CAD softwares. Like mechanical trade, footwear trade also, we are having a specialized CAD system, particularly used for footwear designing and footwear grading and other areas. And the technological know-hows, like we are aware of the latest technology developments, up to date, how we are getting the technological know-how through the participation of international fairs, arranging the international fairs in India, Delhi, India, if I say Delhi, Chennai, every year international fairs are organized by the different agencies. And this all help the people to get updated with the latest technological know-how and international market exposure, again through fairs and buyer-seller meets or buyer-to-customer meets and other things. Then qualified designers, technocrats, their presence, always a value addition to this industry. This can be treated as a very good big strength. Then institutional supports, supports through the different agencies, their policies and their ground team, they can support. Not only that, their government schemes, that is very important to say, the governments through their agency, their government is having a MSMEDI, that is Development Institute, MSME Development Institutes are there. They are functioning in the every part of the country and taking the responsibility to support the industries, local industries. So this I can say the major strength of footwear industry, Indian footwear industry. At the same time, we have to think about the weakness also. The weaknesses we have to improve and overcome that. There is sometimes the awareness of international standards. Like I told you earlier, there are 250 export-oriented units are there. At the same time, there are 5,000 small groups are there, artisans groups are there. They are also running their business in Agra. But unfortunately, they are not aware of the international standards. Because when we are exporting to Germany or when we are exporting to Italy, every country have their own standards. We should ensure the quality of that both country. So we should first aware that what quality they are asking, what are the standards, how much quality parameters to be, which are the parameters to be ensured. Everywhere there is a standards. So as you know, the leather manufactured by the chrome material always have a tendency to create some skin issues or other problems due to using the chrome and other dye coloring materials. So there is a permissible limit. Every chemical, there is a standards. It should be within the particular PPM, parts per million. So there, every country there have clear guidelines that your product should be as per our standards, our country standards. So we should know first what is the standard of other country, then only we can follow that. That is important. Then number of organized manufacturing, like if you see the organized in the sense, they should have a proper registration, they are having a proper export license, they are having a ESA, PEF guidelines, some social compliances, they should have the proper export documents, they are registered with all the agency, export promotion council, like that. There are many documents required, and many people are not aware, or many people don't have the financial or handhold support. So it is very difficult to find organized units in this industry. They are unorganized, or they are managing the day-to-day things that way. Then the production capacity is a big question, because I can see within less time how to improve the production. That I say the productivity, productivity part is less. So that case, the people always have a, the industry is always having a challenge of how to reach the production capacity. Then the supply chain, although the raw material is available, but India is a big country. If we have to bring leather from 1,500 kilometers far away, that it may take a lot of time, and it may take a lot of transportation and cost, and it is very difficult to get the material on time. So supply chain, always the production depends upon the raw material. So if raw material is not there, then that will be affect the entire system. Then other one more weakness is that it's monopolistic approach, like many businesses are handled by a particular group of companies, and they are running, controlling the entire system, their the business ecosystem, and they are holding the things. So sometimes the new players or the low middle level or low level players in economical point of view, they can't come up and fight with the big players. So always there is a challenge for those people. That can be seen as a weakness only. And the multiple components, non-availability of multiple components, that is also a major issue. Then apart from that, the other issues like a brand image, many companies, they don't have a proper brand. They have never tried to create their own brand value or a quality system and reaching to the different people. These are the major weaknesses can be seen. Then productivity, again, how many pairs they are producing footwears per day, it depends upon the labor performance and the timely delivery. When we are going for international market, timely delivery is very important. So that is also a major issue we can see. Then the cost controls system, how to reduce the expenses, judiciously make the materials, resources used. Then some infrastructural issues. These are the major weakness we can see. At the same time, opportunity point of view, yes, we are having good opportunities, like there is a huge scope of pricing potential in domestic market, export potential we are having. Then, as I told earlier, the fairs and buyer-seller meetings are organized. And it is also not only that, it is giving a continuous economic growth to the country and the individuals, and increase disposable income. I can say the income after deducting the tax or social charges. That is called a disposable income. It is increasing the disposable income. Then it's giving a rapid growth in fashion outlook. This is an opportunity, because footwear is related to fashion. It is not a manufacturing industry or a production, but it is mainly related to fashion. It is a part of the dress culture, or it is a part of the fashion system that we are adopting. Not only in India, in all the developing countries, footwear is a fashion concept, that it should be linked with fashion. So definitely there is a lot of opportunities. And e-commerce through the online business, direct selling, that is the customer to manufacturer directly selling to the customer without going through the distribution channel or the sales channel. So always this reducing the cost. There is a consumer and the manufacturer directly linked with the e-commerce. That is also a very important opportunity we can see. Then the quality and deliveries retainability, wherever it is applicable, wherever people are ensuring that always there is a scope of maintaining the customer. Then lot of updation of modern technologies and modern management practices. That is a major role. Then CAD/CAM, as I told you, that is very important for footwear design. 3D CAD are also available in the market nowadays. Then with the support of IT solutions, business can be escalated to the next level. And there is a scope of product diversification. Whenever the product, a particular product is having some downfall in the sales, we can think about the multiple varieties of those particular products into different form, different format or different category, and to diversify the products, the one product into the range of products, and to increase the sale. This is a business strategy. Non-leather footwear sales. As I told you, the footwears are made in leather and non-leather. There is non-leather footwear. Always there is a scope for a market that is also there. Then there is a scope in special footwears. As I told you, apart from general footwear, there is a lot of scope of orthopedic footwears, diabetic footwears, safety footwears. As you know, India, a lot of industries are there, every industry. Safety footwear is must, and there is a big scope in that area. Again, the fourth important factor we have to see the SWOT analysis threats. What are the threats we are facing? So, entry of multinationals. The entry of multinationals always affect the Indian footwear industry and, due to their dominance in price control or they are penetrating into different corners of the market, and they are having an upper hand over Indian manufacturing industry, and they are dumping the overseas product manufactured from China and other countries into India. So always there is a competition to meet the price and other factors. So always it's a very big threat, and fast change in the market, fashion. Whenever there is a change in the fashion, we have to keep up to date ourselves. Then only we can keep knowing the things. Otherwise, we may get outdated. That is also a big threats we are having. Then the inflation, as you know, the cost factor, it's increasing, and it is affecting the cost of the product due to the change in the petrol prices and other raw material prices. There is a volatile in the price situation, and it is not possible to every day the manufacturer or the producer should increase the price. But they should think that what is the raw material cost also. But the raw material cost will keep varying based on the petroleum price and other products. So these are the interrelated things seen as a threat. And the competition is always there between the domestic and the overseas customers. That is also can be seen as a major threat. Then limited scope for fund mobilization, because whenever a project is started, we are having to start a business, we have to generate the fund, and mostly people are not showing much interest in involving in footwear business. But again, it's a very big industry, and there is a lot of scope for getting into things. Then foreign direct investment, also a major threat can be seen. These are the SWOT analysis for Indian footwear industry. Then coming to career opportunity, this is very important. I request you to please spend more attention in this topic, because here we are getting into the different zone. Earlier, what we discussed about is generally about the importance of footwear and the Indian footwear industry. Now we are coming to the human life and its importance. Now, if you see, every human want to prove something in their life. Everybody want to become somebody. So if we say, if anybody want to become, everybody want to be somebody, and somebody means that what somebody, like, they should capable to lead a significant life. They should lead an important life instead of a normal life. So when it comes to importance, means what is the importance? Like you have the liberty to do like you what you want. You have to do whatever you want, whenever you want, and wherever you want, you have to do. So for that, you should have the fulfillment. You should have all the fulfillment, different types of fulfillment in your life, like physical needs, your mental needs, your financial needs, your social needs, and your spiritual needs to be attended. And in those cases, if you are having fulfillment in these five areas, or if you want to achieve the fulfillment in those areas, then always you can think about to lead a significant life. So when we think about the career option, when we make, we want to, everybody want to somebody, that is, there is no doubt. But how to become a somebody, how we can excel in our life, there we come that whenever schooling completed, our 10th standard, 12th standard, graduation or post-graduation, there is four options to go forward. One is to go for a job. There are four types of approach normally people used to do. One is to go for a job, then monthly salary and work. What is the other option? The other option is self-employment. Like you have to self-employ like a professional, make a freelance consultant or doing at your end some activity. And you are earning your bread and butter and you are happy with those activities. Then the third option is to start a business, to become an entrepreneur. So entrepreneur, they have to plan a business. They have to have some concept, some projects, roadmaps, what they are going to make, how they are going to make, what is the investment, how to start, what is the manpower requirement, what is the source of funding, how we are going to sell it, everything to be studied and we have to start. Then there are a lot of other options are like being politicians or other things. So when there is, mostly these are the four different things, job and self-employment, business and other options. So here comes when, what are the factors are influencing a career? When we select a career, we will think, okay, we should have these parameters fulfilled. Then what are the parameters? Then always, obviously, everybody think about the income. Yes, I need a good income. I need a good job satisfaction or a mental peace. I need a growth prospectus. Yes, every 2 years I have I supposed to get learn new things or to get more salary and other things. Then the ownership is that, yes, owner of oneself or owner of others. There are, this way the people will think, yes, I want to be person to the owner of myself. Yeah, I have to be my boss or I have to be the owner of others, like become a business person, how we are controlling or how we are seeing, how we are developing the team, how we are approaching the way. Then the social recognition. Yes, always that is very important. The people will tell, yes, my society should accept me based on my career, my profession and other things. And self-actualization. So it's come self-actualization. Here it means achieving one's full potential. A person is having a maximum potential. So self-actualization, we have to reach the maximum potential in our life. Yes, we have achieved maximum. That level we have to reach. Then life satisfaction and leading healthy life. These are the factors which are influencing the career. Then comes here, we have to decide which career we have to start. When we comes about, talks about the career, business is always a possibility to ingredients, the above ingredients, whatever we have discussed, that can be achieved by a businessman. Yes, by a businessman, always committed to his business, but he can think about whatever he want to do, whenever, wherever he want to do. Yes, we can think about, he's having a possibility to achieve all type of satisfactions, mental satisfaction, physical satisfaction, economical, I mean the financial satisfaction or a spiritual, either, everywhere. You being a businessman, yes, you can earn all the essence of the life or you can experience all the essence of the life without doubt. So, as I pointed out, we have to select our career, how we have to go final, further. And any stream, whatever the stream, we are entering into the thing. When business community always start through a job, that is always better. Why? Learning the market conditions, learning the ground reality is very much important before getting into the entrepreneurial activity. So it is always better to work 1 or 2 years to understand the market, the working systems, labor systems and the laws, guidelines, procedures, knowing that, then we can always think about. So we are thinking about to have a business, we are thinking about to work and start the business. Now it's think about how to, which category, like which industry we have to get into. Here comes like footwear industry, I can show you shoe and allied industry can be a right place with an excellent career opportunity. As I told you, the gravity or the, as I told you, the business point of view or the other point of view, there is a lot of scope in Indian footwear industry. And particularly when anybody wants to start their challenging career or a passion related or passion oriented, then they can get into the footwear industry. It is a very challenging and very it is a very deep rooted business in the Indian footwear, Indian fashion oriented concepts. So coming to the significance, shoe industry significance as a career opportunity, as I told you, it is a labor intensive, there's a lot of scope of the labor intensive, the things are there. Then the job potential, it is not like that only the educated person can do or a less educated or a highly educated, it is not like that. Everybody can do a footwear business, but only thing is they should have the skills and they should have the experience, that way they can come up, go forward. And when it comes to the financial perspective, yes, footwear industry is not, there is immediately I can experience from CFTA that after the course completion, the next day they are starting their work, or many times before 1 month completing, like they are supposed to complete by August, but they are getting placed 1 month before the completion of course. So it's very happy to see, yes, this is a 100% placement oriented training programs were conducted, and there is sufficient demand in the footwear industry for the passed out student. So in those case, yes, again, when you need to come to the salary point and other thing, yes, the starting salary will be vary between 10,000 to 15 or 20,000, because there are a lot of courses we are conducting, and every course the pay level is different. But the real important point we have to observe is that within 3 to 4 years time, the salary may increase 3 to 5 times, like I can say you 300 to 500% will grow further. So this, it depends upon the inputs, how they are putting and how they are grooming themselves and how they are carrying over the industrial atmosphere. We have very lot of examples. So people are at this growing phase. They have started their job in a less salary, but after 5 years they are reached in a very comfortable economical position. That is the important point I have to highlight. Then moreover, when we talk about the business point of view, yes, job, apart from job, business always there is a scope, but this business is, can, we can start in very minimum investment also. There is, it is not required that we have to invest to 500 crores, 200 crores, 100 crores, 1 crore, 2 crore. We can start with a very limited money, maybe 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 3 lakhs also we can start. And in India, we can, I can also highlight that there are industries making more than 5 lakh pairs of footwear per day in their capacity. So you can see it's a very volume business, and a lot of scopes are there. Then the possibilities, then when a person wants to start a own business, yes, there are different areas he can start the things. They can start the auxiliary units, job work units in the sense like they will do the material will be supplied by the customer and we have to complete the work and return it. So they are charged for the particular job what they are performing, and there is no much investment for those people, because they don't want to invest in the material, because material is provided by the customer and they have to manufacture and give it back to the customer. Then the components and other materials of footwears, the footwear upper, insoles, soles, footbeds, this can be manufactured through this business. Then the domestic market, we can make and sell for the domestic customers. Then we can make and sell through online customers. Then we can do the retailer and traders also. There are a lot of scope for that. Then coming to CFTI, so just I will take 10 more minutes to discuss about CFTI. CFTI, Central Footwear Training Institute, It's mainly into developing human resource for footwear and allied industry. So we are mainly into developing the human resource. Human resource, like whenever any industry is there, the industry needs the proper trained manpower. So CFTA responsibility is to produce or develop the human resources through various courses. I can say long-term courses or short-term courses or outreach programs. And this institute established in the year 1963. So you can understand how old it is. Like 1963 is almost 60-year traditional institution. Mahindra, near industrial area, Agra, the footwear hub of India. So I can see some of the responsibility, some of the objectives of the institution. As I told you, the human resource development, modern technology introduction, and consultancy and support service. These are the major objectives of CFTI, or primary objectives rather, I can say. Then activities carried out. We are conducting the long-term, short-term, and need-based training programs, outreach programs. Outreach programs that we are conducting in the different locations of the country. We used to go to different locations and do the training there. There are two options to get trained. One, the candidate can come to CFTI, or we have to go to see the candidate. So outreach programs where we are going to the different locations and contacting them. Then R&D, that is research and development, common facility services. What common facility services means, we are having a machinery and the industry can come and use our machinery in our campus at low cost. So they can use the costly machines, high technology machines in our premises and get manufacture quality products. Our idea is to help the industry to make a quality product. Then techno managerial consultancy and information disseminations. So here comes some of the courses CFTI is offering. So please give your attention to understand what are the different type of courses. The diploma in footwear manufacture and design. This course is a 2-year course, and you can see it is approved by Textile Institute UK. This course is accredited by Textile Institute UK. And the course is conducted as per their syllabus, and they will send a moderator. They will send a moderator from UK every year twice to moderate the work of the students, and it should be as per that course standard. Those people will be allowed to complete this course, and you can see the course fee. It is around 1,39,000 and 20,000 for moderation. So this I can say 1,59,000 course fee for 2 years. So this is the course we are running. It's a very premium course CFTI is running for the footwear fraternity. And this course almost completed 30 batch completed, and 31st batch is running now. So you can see it started in 1996. So you can understand it's running for a long time. And this is one of the premier course of the institute. And then you can see the PG Diploma in Footwear Technology. This is 18 months course. And it falls under level 7 of NSQF, National Skill Qualification Framework. It comes under level 7. And the course fees is around 1,48,000. And there's advanced certificate in footwear design and product development. This course is to create only the designers, footwear designers, and it is around 1,25,000. And advanced certificate in footwear manufacturing technology to create the supervisors, it's around 75,000. And certificate in footwear design and production, 6 months duration, it's 43,000. And certificate in shoe computer aided design, it's around 18,000. So these all the courses are run as per the industry needs. Requirements. 2 year course, 18 months, that is 1.5 year course, 1 year course, 6 months, and 3 months. All are placement oriented programs. After the completion, the candidate will get the job through our institute. We will arrange the campus placements and other direct contact with the industry. And we will arrange the interview for the candidates, and they can get placed after the completion of the course. And the one more interesting fact I want to add is that our students are highly recognized in the industry due to their practical knowledge, due to their skills they are processing. Because this footwear industry is skill-based industry, and mostly 70% of the syllabus covers practical and 30% of the syllabus covers the theoretical part. But in traditional method, you can see the reverse. So 30% practical and 70% theoretical. But here we are insisting more on practical because it's a skill-based industry. And the fee structure, what I told you, so, it is for the different courses, but for candidates falls under scheduled caste and scheduled tribes, that is SCST category, they no need to pay any tuition fees. They are that fees will be reimbursed by Government of India. So there is no requirement to pay the tuition fees. Only they have to pay the raw material and uniform charges. So it is for 125,000 course tuition fees is exempted for the serial number 2, for an example. So only they have to pay 23,000 for the raw material and other expenses. So this I will tell you some of the short-term courses. We are contacting. Short-term is for the 3 months, 2 months, 1 month, 15 days, 6 days, 1 day, this type of programs we are running. And these short-term programs are LSSE approved. LSSE in the sense, Leather Sector Skill Council. Every sector, there are government framed a council for the development of curriculum and development of courses and ensure the training. LSSE is for the leather and footwear. Leather Sector Skill Council is approved courses. And there are various programs we are running, short-term programs in association with CLRA, National SCST Hub, DAPP, Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion, UP Skill Development Mission, Madhya Pradesh Council of Science and Technology, this type of agencies we are operating. As a part of training, we are into national and international leather fairs. We are encouraging our students to participate in fairs. We are arranging the exposure visits. We are giving the market survey-based projects, survey on materials, components and designs, workshops, seminars, interaction with industrialists. These are the different extra activities we are arranging for the students. Also the participation in competitions. We encourage the students to participate in the competitions organized by Council of Leather Exports, Central Leather Research Institute, this type of thing. Then implant training, that is very important to make them industry ready. They will undergo 2 months in implant training to know the export-oriented industry standards, manufacturing practices and systems. Then continuous performances and evaluation through test and other assignments based on the national skill qualification framework. Then also we are doing the sketching, the shoe students, how to sketch the shoes, how to develop the ranges, how to design the shoes. These are all the things. These are all the extra activities for the students to make the learning process more enjoyable and more focused. Then industrial motivation campaigns to get into the entrepreneur activity, entrepreneur development programs, that is technology-based, women-based, this type of EDP-based programs with the help of different agencies. That also we are doing. As I told you, the placement and campus interview we are conducting and every year, right around the year, during the completion of courses, and the pupils are used to get selected. And in case somebody left out, we will place through direct coordination with the industry. And job opportunities, yes, our students are mostly placed as the designers, production supervisors, quality controllers, merchandisers, marketing executives, buying house representatives, and abroad also. Many people are working overseas. And other most important is to become an entrepreneur. We always encourage, instead of going for a job, be a job giver. That is always best, to that we can feel the essence of that particular become a proprietor of an organization. That's a very important feel that can be enjoyed. And the main recruiters, if I say Tata Exports, Bata India Private Limited, Liberty, Relaxo, Farida Group of Institutions, Dabur Footwear Industries, Gupta Overseas, Parks Exports, Metro and Metro, Super House Limited. These are some of the main recruiters engaging our students. Apart from that, the VKC Group is a very important leading domestic footwear manufacturer in India, then Astro Miller, Woodlands, Stadiums, Marks and Spencer's, Eco Shoes, Impactiva, Liner Shoes, Mochiko, and SSI. But these are some of the recruiters. Now I can share you some pictures of our infrastructure, how our designing department works, how our CAD/CAM systems work, how the lab looks, how the practical sessions cutting, how the students are stitching. So they are not going to stitch and sit in the industry, but they should know how the operations they have to do. So for that, they will be provided with a hands-on training. Lasting, how to make a full shoes, computer labs, libraries, classroom. These are the pictures. Some infrastructure about our building and our hostel and other facilities. We are having a dedicated hostel for boys and girls separately with a capacity of 90 occupants with a canteen facility. Some of the products developed by our students, to have an idea, you can see like how the creative-based products are developed by our students. After 1 year, 2 year course, this much better products they can develop. And they can learn from this many things. It's really, we are thanking our team members, staff faculty members for that. Some of the achievements of the students participated in the design competition and getting awarded for the different category of shoemaking. This is the thing. Meanwhile, we also published some books in CFT, also published some books in footwear designing. And some for artisans, how to learn, what is the basic things in the footwear making. So this is all my presentation. Thank you all. Yes. Over to Arun sir. Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir, for enriching with so wonderful information. I have one question, you know. Now, internet and artificial intelligence is very much penetrating in everyone's life.
Yeah.
And there's a term of Internet of Things, IoT. Similarly, yeah. There's one parody of Internet of Health Things.
Yeah.
So in that, you know, now new technology, even shoes can have a sensors that can detect the health perspective in the real time. And also by remote sensing, one can check and keep on track on the health of the person. So do you think, is there need of this, you know, Internet of Health Things incorporated in the shoe industry also? Do we have some futuristic aspect to incorporate this?
Yeah. It's very, very, yeah, it's a really, really, I appreciate your concept. And we are regarding IoT, our industry 4.0, we undergone recently a seminar, the workshop in association with SIPO. SIPO is Singapore Indian Partnership Office. And we rigorously undergone a 1 week program, especially to bring the Industrial 4.0 techniques in our curriculum also. So what we have started now, that we are planning to introduce IoT concept in all our machineries. As you know, this footwear, we can make in 2 lakhs machine also, 20 lakhs machine also. And we are having an infrastructure of more than 4-5 crores of machineries in our institute we are having, including hardware and software. So to monitor the machine with the help of IoT concept and other things, we are really committed and we are working on that direction to implement that. That is one thing. And the second thing, what your input is really... I appreciate that we can link these footwear and the person's health conditions with the help of the sensors or the other equipments, IoT concept, and we can develop. So we are also planning to associate with a couple of experts in those agencies to link between us, because we are mainly not in the particular IoT concept, but yes, we can discuss and come forward jointly to think about that and to develop especially one product for a patent product.
Okay, so thank you so much, sir. On behalf of National Services Scheme, NSS of Dayal Baggage Business Institute, I would like to once again thank you for giving your precious time and to be with us to enlighten with so much information to our students. Thank you so much.
Thank you. All the best for our staff, students and staff members. Take a wonderful activity today.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.